Buying a home is a significant part of the American dream. But saving enough money for a down payment is usually the biggest obstacle for first-time homebuyers. According to the National Association of Realtors, the average down payment on a home is around 11% of the purchase price. This translates to $33,000 on a $300,000 mortgage. 11% can add up to a significant amount of money. Plus, you will usually have to pay 2% to 5% for closing costs. The amount you put down will help determine your monthly payments, so it's an important factor for homebuyers. One method that some people use to finance their down payments is to tap into retirement accounts, such as a 401k. There are two ways to use a 401k to finance a home purchase: borrow from it and withdraw money from it. Here are the pros and cons of these two options. Borrowing from your 401k. If you would like to borrow from your 401k to fund a home purchase, then you must do it through a 401k loan. A 401k loan is a loan that lets you borrow a certain amount of money from your 401k at a set interest rate. As with a standard loan, the money that you borrow will have to be repaid within a certain period of time. Not all 401k plans allow for loans, so the first thing you should do if you are thinking about taking out a 401k loan is to check with your employer to see if your plan permits loans. A 401k loan has many advantages. First of all, it can be accessed quickly. In fact, in most circumstances, 401k loans can be obtained within a few days and just take a few clicks of a mouse to obtain. So, if a house you love suddenly pops up on the market at a good price and you need cash immediately to buy it, a 401k loan may be an excellent option. Another key advantage of 401k loans is that they typically do not require credit checks and lengthy applications. Why not? Because you are borrowing money from yourself, so you are the only party taking on risk. The loan origination fees for 401ks also tend to be low compared with other types of loans. This is another nice benefit of 401k loans. Additionally, unlike other types of loans, the interest that you pay back on your loan goes to you. You will not have to spend money making interest payments to a financial institution or to another lender. However, although 401k loans have many advantages, there are also some disadvantages. For example, payments on the loan are not considered 401k contributions. So, if your employer has a 401k match, your employer will not match payments you make on the loan. If you take a 401k loan and then leave your job, you must repay the loan before you file taxes for the year in which you left your job. Otherwise, it's considered a withdrawal and taxed at ordinary income tax rates. For instance, if you had a loan on your 401k and left your job in October, you would have until April 15th of the following year to repay the loan. Another disadvantage for some people is the limit on how much you can borrow. The IRS limits the amount of money that can be borrowed through a 401k loan to the lesser of 50% of your account balance, or $50,000. If you are trying to buy a $1 million home, then borrowing from your 401k will most likely not be the best option. Additionally, you probably have to repay your 401k loan within 5 years and make payments at least quarterly. Some plans will give a borrower a longer repayment window, up to 15 years, if the loan is for the purchase of a primary residence. One last disadvantage of a 401k loan is that it can make it more difficult to qualify for a mortgage. Taking out a 401k loan pushes your debt-to-income ratio higher, which is not ideal when you're trying to qualify for a mortgage. According to Brian Sullivan, Public Affairs Manager for the Department of Housing and Urban Development, HUD, when somebody borrows money against their retirement fund, of course, that would impact their debt-to-income ratio. When somebody is borrowing to borrow, that might negatively impact their qualifications for the loan itself just by virtue of the added debt burden that they would bring to transaction. Withdrawing money from your 401k. If you do not want to get a 401k loan for your down payment, then withdrawing money is another option. However, like borrowing money from your 401k, there are pros and cons to withdrawing money from your 401k. The first thing that you need to know about making a 401k withdrawal is that many employer plans simply do not allow 401k withdrawals before the age of 59 and a half. Check with your plan provider or employer to see if a withdrawal is even an option. Many employers allow 401k withdrawals before this age, under certain circumstances. One of these circumstances is financial hardship. But your employer may require you to demonstrate that you are experiencing financial hardship before they allow you to make a withdrawal. If you are able to make a withdrawal from your 401k, there are many advantages to using it as a funding source. For example, the money does not have to be repaid. Also, unlike a 401k loan, the IRS does not set a limit regarding how much you are allowed to withdraw. Furthermore, you will not be required to pay any interest on your withdrawal. This is a great benefit. Now for the disadvantages. If you are under the age of 59 and a half, you will be charged a 10% early withdrawal fee. So, right off the bat, you lose 10% of the money you take out. But that is not all an early withdrawal will cost you. The withdrawal is considered income, so you will pay federal and state taxes on the amount withdrawn. For example, if you withdraw $100,000 from your 401k before you reach age 59 and a half, you will pay $10,000 in early withdrawal fees plus taxes. If you're in the 24% tax bracket, that's another $24,000 in federal taxes. So, $34,000 is a steep price to pay for some quick cash. Which option should you choose? The option that is best for you depends on what your goals are and which downsides you are willing to deal with, as both options have downsides. The biggest downside of 401k loans is that they have to be paid back. The biggest downside of 401k withdrawals is that you will take a massive tax hit. If your top priority is to prevent losing a lot of money, then you should consider going with the 401k loan. However, if your top priority is to not have to pay back any money that you take out, then you should go with the 401k withdrawal. Regardless of which option you take, your 401k will still take a big hit, at least temporarily. Removing any money invested in a tax-deferred retirement plan will prevent you from earning the compound interest that you gain if you leave the money in your 401k. Please like, share, and subscribe to our channel.